Hi, Madeline here from Sonic Bloom with a new episode of the Ableton Live Insider Tips. And this time it's all about the collections and particularly about where the collections are saved on your computer so that you can make a backup or copy it to your second computer that you can have live installed on. And the answer for this is actually really simple. It's simply stored as part of the user library. And so if you're not sure where the user library is currently installed on your computer, you can simply go into the Live Preferences and then go to the Library tab. And then here you can see location of user library. And in my case, it's saved under Music, Live 11 and User Library. So I'm gonna go to this place in Finder and unfold this, and here you can see the Ableton folder info folder, and in there you'll find one or possibly also two or so XMP files, and this is simply where all the tagged presets, samples, plugins, whatnot that you can tag in Live's browser are stored in. And so either you can simply take this folder and copy this onto your other computer so you can have the same system of tagged presets in your collection, or you can back up the whole user library if you prefer that, which might also make sense depending on how you work. And I'm gonna link a video as well how you can make the user library always automatically accessible and updated on both of your computers if you have to, so that you can add new things to your collections, or if you have, you know, other things stored in your user library on one computer, that you will always have it automatically be updated on the other one without having to copy things back and forth. The only thing that is not stored in this XMP file is actually the name. So if you rename anything, like here I've renamed it samples, and you copy it to another computer, then this is going to be called Orange again. So all you have to do is either do a right click, click rename, or you can use the shortcut for it. Just going to use the shortcut, and then, you know, I could just rename it on the new computer, and that's it. So, and last but not least, I just want to show you the XMP file. I've already opened that with, in my case, Text Wrangler, but you can use any text software that you have on your computer. I just like using Text Wrangler for this. And here you can see it's an XMP file. And here you've got the file path of the devices and everything saved. And this is how the tagged files turn up in the browser under your collections. And in my case, that's not very much. That's all I have at the moment. But others might have a huge collection, and then it would be much, much more useful to have a backup or have that running on both computers. Well, that's it. I hope you find this useful. Yeah, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you next time. Bye.